Hi, this is Danya Nambia, your personal transformation coach and the KL Sky Clinic certified life coach. What time is it right now? It is story time. I had a client come to see me specifically because she was constantly attracting conflict and drama in her life all the time. And what was frustrating to her is, as far as she is concerned, she does everything in her power not to get into situations where there is drama and conflict. But no matter where she went, it didn't matter if it was at the school she was teaching, if it was with her husband and her kids, if it was with her friends, she's always attracting drama. So what is that about? When we started digging into her history, into her past, what we found out was her parents were almost always in some form of an argument or another. So what she experienced in the primary years of her life is that from the ages of 0 to 14 years old, she always saw conflict around her. And drama and yelling and shouting, and there was even physical abuse in her home. So as a child, what happened was when she saw this in her environment, she made it mean that if you love somebody, then you care enough about them to shout at them and yell at them because you want their life to be better. And so actually, when people are being mean to you or abusive, to her, it meant that they love you. They care about you. So even when she became an adult, she didn't realize that subconsciously, she kept creating situations in her life where she would always get into conflict because on a subconscious level, she believed this is what love really is. So what we had to do is, first of all, the first step, which is the greatest step, is becoming conscious of what your pattern is in the first place. So once you know what your pattern is, then the next step is you have to make a choice. Is this what you want to believe for your life? Or would you like to create a new life, a new meaning? So now what we did is we asked her to create a new definition for love. What does love look like to you now? What would you like it to be? So instead of fights and conflict and disagreement and criticism, she started to feel things like empathy, understanding, patience, nurturing. So now she has created these new associations with the word love. And when she gets into situations where there is conflict, she has a new resource. Because she already knows what her beliefs were, when she gets into a situation of conflict, she gets to pause and bring this new definition of love into the picture. Because she knows this is what she wants as love, that's what she has to consciously practice doing. And it's not easy, and she is still in a process of learning and growing as we speak. But what is amazing is she has noticed a significant change in her partner, her friends. In fact, she had to actually lose a few of her friends, but she didn't mind it at all because it is actually what she really, really, really desired. She wanted more harmonious and loving relationships. The other cool thing about what we discovered is as we were digging into her past, she also became self-aware that she's somebody who really needs a lot of excitement and stimulation, a sense of adventure. And so when she doesn't do that in her life, when she doesn't find that sense of adventure by going out with her friends or, you know, exploring new places, what happens is she creates that sense of drama in her personal life with her husband, because it also kind of creates the same kind of feeling of adventure, you know? So by combining these two different aspects of understanding what her pattern of behavior was and her understanding of what love was in the past, plus now also using this new resource, which is that she needs stimulation or a sense of adventure or spontaneity in her life. By doing both of this, she has managed to shift the quality of her relationships in her life. So I hope this story helps you in also reflecting about what your definition of love is. What does love really look like to you? And are you practicing the kind of love that you would like to receive? This is the power of becoming aware of your own beliefs and your subconscious mind. Hope you have a good week. Bye.